So this is the future scooter lab project here at UniSA, which is sponsored by Beam. And my name is Dan McLean. I'm the program director of the product design program.
My name's Andrew Whitaker and I'm a lecturer here at UniSA. So I'm basically mentoring the postgraduate students in this project that we're doing in conjunction with Beam Scooters.
We're working with Beam at the moment on the future of shared mobility, micromobility. And the first step in that project is an electric scooter redesign, and also considering the services that go on around that electric scooter product as well. So we've had our first year students looking at it from a sketching point of view. We've had second year students looking at it from a human factors point of view, and our postgraduate students are looking at the complete package.
Postgraduates, they're the ones that I'm really, mentoring and assisting with this project. So the start point for this is to observe people using scooters. From there they go through, they come up with different theories on how they're being used, what could possibly be improved, a concept development stage, some testing via prototypes.
So we're looking at the physical product itself, we're looking at the brand itself. We're looking at the service design aspects of the project as well, so the app, the interface, and how usable that is. Things like the share, scooters have helmets, for example, and that's a big part of the service as well, is making sure we can come up with a solution to a shared helmet.
So coming from the undergrad course, where the projects are really confined, really safe, and then jumping onto a client project, it sort of really opens like the real world of design, you know, real constraints, real challenges.
Over the course of the semester we might have three or four presentations where Beam attend. They've invited us to their workshop here in Adelaide, where we've had the opportunity to go behind the scenes and see how the Beam service works.
Okay, so this is an interesting project. Electric micromobility is the future, I suppose. So they're challenging because they're dynamic, they're moving, and we're expecting the public to hop on these things and be safe and get from point A to point B.
The biggest challenge is definitely the human interactions side of it. So just working out how people are going to naturally be standing and interacting with the scooter that we're making.
The biggest design challenges for this project, I think probably it's that we have to design for a broad spectrum of people.
Biggest challenges would sort of have to be designing for the problems that are either really stupidly simple or really, really complex. Like, we're really focusing on the in-between.
The only way to do this is to test them, to ride them, to make prototypes, and try and simulate as close as possible, you know, actually using the scooter.
Yeah, our ambition at the end of this year is to have a semi-working prototype that we can present to Beam, with improvements in terms of the aesthetics, in terms of the usability, human factors, and those areas. And then we're going to continue the project in 2023, where we can take on board the feedback from Beam and push that project a lot further.